physical fitness. Oh. That was a style of theatre that really actually made me challenge myself, which for me was actually a very good thing. I was actually quite happy that I was challenged. Because me as a performer, I believe that no matter what stage anyone is at, you know, there's always room for improvement. And, you know, this unit, you know, really basically just proved, you know, what I was saying, you know, yeah, I've had past jobs in West End and, you know, doing professional performances, for example, like Lion King, for example, I've had past experience working there, playing the role of Simba, you know, I can say to myself, yes, I've experienced the life of, you know, West End and the life of a performer, but, you know, I decided to take a pause in all that and sort of build myself up purely because of my belief in there's always room for improvement. And this unit has really allowed me to prove that point and actually allow me to improve myself because, you know, because I would like to go back into the industry again. But this time I can say to myself, I have got more skills than I had before when I was first in the industry, you know. And I can gladly say physical theatre is one of them. You know, I get a lot of physical skills. And some of them are actually quite challenging, you know. My stamina, for example, my strength and my flexibility, you know, those physical skills actually has improved so much, you know, in my performance. You know, it was a lot of movement, you know, so my stamina, a lot of stamina it was required, you know, in the performance, because there was no stop. Even when we were off stage, it was only for a couple of seconds, or we had to rush to the other side, or, you know, it was like clockwork, it was non-stop, it was always moving, it was always moving. And for me, you know, in the beginning, that was quite challenging. If I'm gonna be honest, it was quite challenging at first, purely because my stamina wasn't necessarily quite strong. Whereas now, you know, I can definitely say my stamina has improved because I was sweating and, you know, I was really worked out by, you know, the end of the performance. But I was able to continue my performance, you know, and able to maintain my strength within my performance. So, you know, I didn't get tired to the stage where I just slacked in some of my movements or anything like that. No, purely because, you know, every single day before we before we started rehearsing, we'd have a warm up, purely because, you know, we had to ensure that our bodies were safe and warmed and stretched, and our minds were, you know, awake before we started doing physical theatre. Because, you know, as I mentioned, physical theatre requires a lot of physical skills, and if your body is not warmed up, if it's not stretched, you know, if your mind's not woke, and, you know, you can cause a lot of damage, and, you know, you won't have that support during your performance, and can cause long-term damage, you know, And, you know, that was one thing we would always conduct. And I would, you know, I would actually, I used to generally take charge of the warm up. So, you know, when we didn't have our physical theatre sort of tutor, Stephen, I would usually take charge of the warm up. So I'll first start off with, you know, some cardio to allow the blood pumping, to get some blood into our brains and sort of get our heart beating, you know, sort of getting everyone's energy up. You know, that was quite, that was very important, and you know, something that we needed to do. So yes, yeah, so I start off with a bit of cardio. Then I would start. I'll do some core work. So that includes plank. You know, that includes doing, you know, some sort of, you know, sit-ups and all those kind of things, because we had to learn how to engage our core, because our core is the central everything. You know, if we can, you know, like engage our core and really use our core, we can allow so much more movement, and we'll have so much more control in our movement. You know, for example, if someone was doing a pirouette, if no one, if they weren't using their core, they weren't training their core, they won't have balance, for example. You know, it's using the use of your core is very important for physical theatre. You know, and being able to use it would allow us to expand our movements and make our movements look 10 times more stronger than it would have if we didn't warm our core. And you know, strengthen our core. So yeah, so after some core work, we'll do I would do some stretches from head to toe. So I'll start off with the head, work down, well, start off from the neck really, work down to the shoulders, which also included the arms, so the elbows, wrist, and fingertips. Then would work with some isolation of the rib cage, and the arms as well. And then worked down to the waist. And then we would, I'd also conduct a warm up for our backs, so our posture, and you know, ensuring that our posture was strong, because you know, our backs, our spinal cord is the most important part of our body. You know, if we were to damage it, it would definitely cause a long-term damage, and we had to ensure that, you know, that wouldn't happen. You know, so yeah, so I would conduct a warm-up for our back, so ensuring our posture is strong, and then I would work down to our waist. So, you know, do some rotation within the waist, and then afterwards I would start off with the legs. I start off with the our thigh, and then work down to our calves, to our ankles, and to our foot, to our you know, to our feet. You know, we'd actually also do some ballet techniques. You know, tendus, for example, you know, you know, all those kind of techniques, purely because it will allow us to have more control of our movements. So doing that was also one thing that allowed us to have a stronger performance physically. So yeah, so anyways, I would always, yeah, conduct a warm up to ensure the safety of our body. And you know, all of this, just that really allowed me to build my skills up. Build my skills as a choreographer. Being able to identify specific parts of the body that requires to be warmed up. Acknowledging health and safety, you know, before we do anything physically challenging. You know, all of this built, you know, just the warm up itself in this unit already allows me to build up so much skills, you know, all of the things that I mentioned, you know, and by doing that, it allowed me to really do well and really achieve the best. But yeah, as well, my devising skills, accuracy, my timing, you know, improvisation, you know, the use of contact and relationships, and you know, using the labrum's movement style, for example. You know, all those things, those little elements, allowed me to really build myself as a performer. You know, this unit has really challenged me to face new things, try new things. You know, in the class discussion that we had, which is in this Padlet as well, you know, I mentioned how at first I never did physical theatre before. I never really used to think of trying or anything like that. But, you know, ever since I did physical theatre, I have built up the idea of trying new things, trying new styles, trying new skills, you know, trying a lot of things, you know, actually go out there and challenge myself, because in the end of the day, it's going to benefit me. Because I can say to myself, okay, I possess this skill now, I possess this skill, I possess this skill. And, you know, doing this unit and do physical theatre allowed me to do that. It allowed me to challenge myself. And that's one thing that I definitely appreciate, you know. The skills that, you know, I gained from it, I can now apply in my future projects, you know. And the skills doesn't just require my performance skills. It actually also includes the technical skills and the maker skills. You know, I first talk about the maker skills, for example. So, you know, my research skills wasn't quite strong at first. But after this unit, you know, being in control of this entire production, my research skills have boosted up ridiculous amount, you know, digging deep, you know, as you know, and that doesn't just require us looking at one or two videos that says about subliminal messages, no, it means learning about the writer, you know, learning about you know, why that character is that way, you know, identifying all those kind of things, you know, like Lewis Carroll, he's the writer of, you know, Alice in Wonderland. You know, there was a lot of sort of superstitions about him, sort of things that he used to be interested in. You know, for example, there was an actual little girl called Alice, and he had a relationship with the character Alice. Not in the sense as they were together, but them two had a strong bond together, and you know, that, for example, was one thing that surprised me, because we looked at how, you know, everything that was said to other people and linking to Lewis Carroll's life, you see the connections and you see the darker elements. So the caterpillar, for example, smoking, you know, it's just the way the scene is set, it seems like he is intoxicated, which would link to a hookah, which would link to marijuana, you know. And Lewis Carroll used to, you know, spend his time in a crack den, which was a place where people just go and sort of do their drugs, you know. So that's, you know, that's one character there already explained, you know, is based on the idea of using drugs. You know, the same thing with the mushroom. Mushrooms also links to drugs. The idea of drugs, you know, the hallucinogens. So, you know, when the caterpillar blows its smoke, creating letters, creating shapes, you know, something that smoke doesn't necessarily do. You know, so that was one thing that was quite surprising for me, because just that little amount of research, I was able to identify so much new things. You know, for me, I grew up knowing Alice in Wonderland as a happy and, you know, a happy story. But little did I know there was a lot of dark elements within it. So that there itself is just one example of how just a little bit of research can allow one piece to really grow big and, you know, allow you to really expand your knowledge. Because then afterwards you could use what you've learned and what you've researched and put in your performance to educate your audience. You know, if that's what your target is. Your target is to educate them. That's one thing that, you know, there is something that you could do. You know, what you've researched, you've now decided to, you know, apply it and convey that in your piece, which is what we did. So now the audience can say, "Whoa, okay, I didn't know this about that character. I didn't know about this about Alice in Wonderland in general." So, you know, that was one thing. I really built up, you know, as a performer, you know. Focusing on the maker's aspect and researching, deep researching, more like, you know, if it wasn't for the research, our performance wouldn't be what it was. Do you know, like my character, for example, Marge, links to someone with an addiction, you know, his addiction is tea, but in reality, it was something else. It was just the, you know, again, relating to the idea of drugs, and, you know, and how the twitch is, you know, all that sort of stuff, sort of being all over the place, you know, bouncing off the walls and all that stuff, you know. Applying that, you know, doing the research, allowed me to convey that in my work, in the way I moved. You know, I was able to show, okay, this is how my character acts, this is how my character moves, and this is what my aim was. My aim was to really, really convey my character and what the deep meaning of my character was, and me doing that allowed, you know, me doing that research allowed me to do that. Now, another skill that I also possessed was the technical side. So I was the musical director / producer. So I was in charge of all the music, merging music, applying sound effects, and all that stuff. And, you know, I used a simple software of GarageBand on my laptop, which allowed me to, you know, allowed me to do what was needed to do. You know, I did a lot of research on how to use GarageBand, you know, by watching video clips and, you know, learning how to merge songs and really sort of zoom into the music and really find the precise moment where the music can easily blend in or fade in and fade out into, you know, because instead of, you know, one music going from one beat and then jump into a completely different tune, I was able to sort of match them. It wouldn't be necessarily bang on, but I was able to match them where it had a smoother transition. So, you know, learning that is now a skill that I can say, okay, cool, because now if I'm in a rehearsal and, you know, we decided that we're not going to use entire music, or we want to add a specific sound effect, or we want to merge two music together, or we want to transition from one music to another music, I could quickly do that on my laptop. Not have a finishing piece, but something that will allow us to apply physical work, you know, apply choreography to it, for example, if you're creating the dance, you know, and that was good. Like, that's one skill that I now possess. You know, another technical skill I actually also learned was lighting. You know, I was also in charge of the lighting of the whole performance. So I went up to the lighting desk with one of our tutors, Yoli, and she taught me, you know, a lot of things about, you know, lighting. So, for example, where each light are positioned, why they're positioned in that way, you know, the use of LED lights, whitewash lights, and just regular lighting, spotlights. You know, for example, yes, you could mix all sorts of colours and everything like that on stage, but all of those colours can sort of fade the performer. So applying, for example, a little bit of spotlight, depending on where the, you know, performer is staying, you know, positioned on stage, you know, applying a bit of spotlight, whether it's, you know, center, whether it's on stage left or stage right, or, you know, whether it's downstage or upstage, you know, applying that little bit of spotlight to sort of create an outline of the body so the audience can still see the facial reaction, the movement of the character, but still have that light effect was something that I learned, you know. And I actually physically did it. I conducted a stop and start run through of the whole performance, where we'd go from one scene to the next scene to the next scene, and set the lines for it. So we picked colours that suited the scene, specific light states and how bright it was, because obviously we didn't want to put too much, we didn't want to put it too low, you know. So, you know, doing that, you know, I got to really see the technical side of putting a performance on. It's not just going up to, you know, our tutor Yoli and just say, yeah, we want this colour, and that colour. I went there myself and, you know, I learned how to use the desk. You know, I could say to myself, yeah, I know how to use that desk now. So if we're in a rehearsal, I can just go and set the light without having to wait for someone to do it for me. You know, and that is one skill that I know I now possess. You know, I possess that skill now. That's one skill that I have developed, and I would actually also like to develop more. You know, and hopefully in my future project, I'll be able to do that. I'll be able to apply those skills. So, you know, I did gain a lot of skills in this entire process. Skills that I now know, I'd like to develop a lot more. So, you know, me, myself, I can, you know, apply those skills that I've learned into my future, you know, into my future project. And for me, that's what's important, because it's not a factor of just doing something and then forgetting about it. It's a factor of learning the skill and keeping that skill, because, you know, in our future, we can, you know, who knows, we might be able to, you know, apply it. And for me, that is something I can do. I can now say to myself that, you know, in the future, if there's no one to, you know, sort out lighting for us or anything, I can go up there and, you know, sort lighting. I'll just get someone to cover for me on stage, you know, whilst I set the lighting for everyone, and, you know, that's it. There you go. I'm done. And I'm done. That's it. The lighting's sorted and everything. And for me, and that's all I want. That's all I want to do. All I want to do is just constantly improve my skills. I want to build, you know, my skills. So if you know, as you can see in my Padlet, there's a survey that me and my class conducted, and every single statement I strongly agreed with. So the first statement, I have a better understanding about the making process of a physical theatre performance piece. Strongly agree. Because, you know, I understand now. It's not the factor of just getting into a space and just start waving your arms around and start creating movements that just first pop something into my head. No, it's a factor of researching first. Identifying key characteristics of my character, for example, you know, find out why that person moves in that way, and then put myself in that position, in the sense as, if I was this character, I know that I would move like this because of whatever it is, and it goes on and on and on. So, you know, I can now say that I do have a better understanding of the making process of a physical theatre. You know. The next statement was, I have developed a new or refined devising choreographic production skills. Again, strongly agree. You know, in this entire unit, I took the role of a director, I took the role of a choreographer, a music director / producer, a lighting technician. You know, I took a lot of roles in this unit, and roles that, again, I want to further on because I still think this, I still improve, but it's a beginning stage for me now. You know, the other statement, I have developed a new or refined physical theatre performance skills. Yes, you know, doing this, I have challenged myself so much, you know, in the physical theatre aspect that, yeah, I can say to myself, yes, I have new skills within the physical theatre, and I would like to develop them even more. I'd like to try things, you know, in the physical theatre style that I didn't get to try in this unit, you know. Another quote, statement, I have learned something new from this assignment. Again, strongly agree. I am proud of the performance of Alice. Yeah, I agree. I agree with it. But like I said earlier, I do believe it could have been much stronger than it was. But for what we went through as a company and stuff, I do think we did very well. And the final statement was, has this performance changed your attitude about your potential as a performer? Again, strongly agree. Yes, it has. Because for me, I'm now going to have a wider view in the idea of theatre. So instead of just sticking to one style, you know, trying new styles. You know, this unit allowed me to try physical theatre now, you know. Now I'd like to try a different style of theatre. Miming, for example, any style, you know. This unit has allowed me to have a more open mind about the arts, you know, in general, you know, not just the physical side of it, you know, the technical side of it, the making of it, and, you know, all of those things, you know, this unit has really allowed me to, you know, have that open mind to try out those new things, and that's something I definitely want to do now. I definitely want to try new things. I want to face new challenges every day. You know, all those things will eventually make me become a very strong performer, and that's all I want. I want to be a strong performer. I want to do well. I want to show my passion that I have for performing arts. And, you know, doing this and having an open mind will allow me to achieve that. It will allow me to create what I need to do to achieve my goal as, you know, as an upcoming performer. But I'm pretty proud of myself. You know, I feel like me as an individual, it was very successful unit for me. Purely because that I have learned a lot, I have achieved a lot, and I have built up stronger as a performer than I originally started. So, yeah, this was my evaluation for my Alice in Wonderland piece. That happened in June 18th, 2018. Thank you.